This week on the show, Go Gets Grilled. Hello and welcome to Go Kamloops. I'm your host, Sam Numsen. Thank you so much for tuning in this week. Summer is here, which also means the official kickoff of barbecue season, and that's why we're here at Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. Today we're going to meet with executive chef Darren Bezanson to find out what he's got planned for our barbecue meal today. Why don't we head inside and get started? All right, so here we are, Darren, executive chef. Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah, so you're kind of a grill expert, we could say, here at Hoodoos at Sun Rivers.
Sort of. Yeah, I'd love to dab a little bit in the grill.
Cool. So, what are some things people should consider when they're either purchasing a grill, firing it up for the first time for the year? What do they have to think about?
Well, if you're purchasing a grill, one of the things to really keep in mind is the amount of BTUs. I can't remember what BTU stands for right off the top of my head.
Sounds scientific.
Yeah, very. But the thing is to remember, you want at least 40,000 BTUs, and the only reason why I suggest that is because it gives it a little bit more recovery time. So when you open the lid and closing the lid, and you're turning things and moving things around on the barbecue, the lower the BTUs, like around 10,000, your grill gets really cold fast.
Okay.
So the more the BTUs, the quicker the recovery time is on the grill.
So retains heat, I guess?
Okay. Exactly. So when you open it up and you're moving steaks around that, the recovery time is a lot quicker, you get a much more even cooking heat.
What are some things you should do when you're kind of just getting ready to throw your first steaks on the grill for the year, for the summer?
Well, just to get it prepared though, you obviously want to give it a nice good cleaning, clean it all up, get your grills nice and, as you can see, we've got it all nicely cleaned up here, ready to go for the grill. When it's all corroded with all a bunch of stuff in the bottom and that, the heat isn't quite as even. Okay. So you got a bunch of stuff that's building up on your grills and stuff like that, on the flame and that. So you want to make sure that it's clean, so you have everything is nice and clean and ready to go for when you're putting food on.
So not just for aesthetic, but for actual practicality.
Absolutely.
Well. Okay, and what are we gonna make today?
Well, we've got steaks today, and one of the things that's really important is all these barbecues that you see nowadays all have like a little temperature gauge here. When you're just starting out ready to put your steaks or your whatever items you're going to put on the grill, make sure you have a nice good hot temperature, because with that hot temperature then you get a nice even sear on the food. And when it's cold, you're just going to fight with your food, it's going to stick, and it's just not going to come out as nice as you want it to.
Great. And we want it to come out nice.
Absolutely.
So coming up on Go, we're actually going to throw some things on the grill and get cooking here, but first let's meet some members of the Kamloops Archery Club. Welcome back to Go Kamloops here from Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. Joining me again is Chef Darren. We're spending the day learning all about grilling, getting things on the grill now that summer is here. So we've gone through kind of our grill maintenance, cleaned it up, dusted it off after a long, cold winter. We're going to make some steaks. So why don't you take us through what's on the menu today?
What I've got here today is I've got a New York strip loin. And one of the things to remember that when you're looking for the right steak to put on the grill, and that if you look for just the ending of loin, so you got strip loin, tenderloin, sirloin, those are the best ones for grilling and that. So that's where you kind of want to go with your steaks and that. There is also like prime rib steaks and that, which are always really nice to put on the grill. But when you get to that, like I said, the ends in loin, you're pretty safe to go. But don't be afraid to ask your butcher, ask somebody in the meat department just what is best for grilling and that. But
the butchers are our friends.
Absolutely. Some of the things to remember too is that when you have your steak, you want to look at whether it's like the Angus reserve that we use is on the higher end of the side, then you go down to AAA, AAA, but as you go down, and if it's not even graded, the chances are it's gonna be fairly tough meat.
Okay.
And when you get to those like lower grades, that's when you wanna get into marinating that. When you have like just a really nice high-end steak, you wanna just be very basic, because all I've got on here is just a little bit of Montreal steak spice and some olive oil, which is my favorite thing to do.
So a higher quality steak means you don't need to do as much to it.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah, and one thing to remember too is before you put your steak on, actually put your oil onto the product. Don't oil your grill, because it's super hot, it's just gonna catch on fire.
We don't want that.
No, we don't want that. So when you put your steak on, just you get that nice sizzle because it's nice and hot.
Are those grill marks you mentioned? Is that what's happening right now?
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to get, how the grill mark actually came to be is that the big steakhouse and that, they have like giant grills with all the different steaks on. So the person, if someone leaves the grill, the next person coming on will know that this is step one, step two, step three, step four. So then you get to see, you know exactly where the steak is in the cooking process.
Nowadays it just looks cool.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. What else I'm going to do here too is I'm going to do a few veggies on the side. When you do veggies too, they won't take very long at all. So you just want to give them just a quick little grill. And it's the same thing. Make sure it's nice and hot before putting it on. And these here, all I've got is a little bit of olive oil, some balsamic, some garlic, salt and pepper. Really basic, really easy. Because food has got its own natural flavors, and we want to take away from that by adding a bunch of stuff to it. What I've got up here though is like I've got a few potatoes I've done up ahead of time, and so they're kind of in that package there, just kind of cooking through.
And they need to actually fully cook through,
yeah.
I guess.
So you can do baked potatoes on the grill. I usually like to use the top rack, just putting them on the bottom rack there to get that direct hot heat. So then it you have a chance of it kind of burning. So on the top rack, it takes a little bit longer, but it's a little bit safer to for cooking in that.
And you have a little special sauce, or are we not going to worry about that?
We're going to put that on once we flip it over.
All right, well, we'll learn more about the special sauce coming up here on Go Kamloops from Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. But first, let's get to this week's community calendar with Alexis. Thanks so much for tuning in to Go Kamloops here from Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. We've spent the day barbecuing, lots of fun. People, of course, are spending the days barbecuing now that it's summer. Made a delicious meal here. I'd like to say I made it, but really, Executive Chef Darren made it. So everything's pretty much done. That looks like a nice special sauce though on the steak. Why don't you tell us what that is?
Absolutely, this is my signature, it's a honey bourbon barbecue sauce.
Honey bourbon?
Yeah. So we got a little bit of, it's got some local honey in there, it's got some nice molasses and a few other secret ingredients which I will actually reveal to you guys. I'll give it to you guys to put on your Facebook page for everybody to be able to enjoy.
Yeah, we'll do that. So you'll have to check our Shaw TV Kamloops Facebook page after the show. Now, I guess it's one thing to cook the food, make sure it tastes good, but the presentation is always the key.
Absolutely. No, that's the first thing we do is we eat with our eyes, right?
Yeah.
So when it hits the table, everyone's just like, they want to give that ooh and that ah.
Even at home, you know, it's one thing to go out for dinner, but why not spend a little time and make your dinner at home look nice too, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So we're gonna
do ways?
So what we're going to do is we're just going to start. We have these potatoes that we've been doing up in here, they've got a little bit of flavor in there with the onions and that. So we're just gonna start it into the center of the plate. Just like so. And our steak is just gonna join the potatoes. We have the veggies here.
Even though it's on the grill, there's a nice mix of colors too.
Absolutely, you want to have those vibrant colors. That's what makes everything so much nicer. You have those colors that just pop out. And so then that's it, nice and easy.
Delish. What are your favorite things about grilling? It's nice to get out in the summer and sure take everything out of the kitchen and spend some time on the patio.
Absolutely, it's just being outdoors is the main thing. But the flavor is just so much better than just throwing it in the oven, right? You get all that flavor off the grill. Things like, I love doing ribs. If you're gonna do ribs, make sure you boil them out for about 2 hours, especially the pork ribs. For about 2 hours, they'll get them nice and tender. So when you put them on the grill and you put that barbecue sauce on there, you just get nicely caramelized on there. It gives that nice flavor. Chicken and that, you wanna do very much the same as you would with a steak. If you can get it with the skin on, you get that skin nice and crispy, it's so much better. Everyone wants to take it off these days, but you need to get all that flavor out of the skin and that.
Thank you so much, Darren.
Thank you very much.
Awesome, looks delicious. Coming up on Go Kamloops, we're going to learn about some wine pairings for this delicious meal we made here at Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. Welcome back to Go Kamloops here from Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. Chef Darren just made a delicious steak here, as you can see. One thing that goes really well with a good meal, though, is a good wine.
Absolutely.
Yes, so joining me is Leon, the resident sommelier here at Hoodoos. So tell me a little bit about the importance of kind of pairing the right wine with the right meal.
Sure. It can obviously make or break the meal. You know, we've all been in that situation where you've had the food and then all of a sudden the wine just tastes really bland or vice versa.
So pairing one might overpower the other.
Exactly, yeah. So it's really important that when you're thinking about pairing your food and wines, it's all about balance, and you don't want anything to overpower the food, and you don't want anything to overpower the wine. It really is a fine balance. Okay. I love to pair wines, especially with barbecue steak. You know, it doesn't get any better than that for me.
No kidding. Especially here.
I know.
In Kamloops.
Yeah, which we get to do for a lot longer than most other parts of Canada.
So what would you think about first when you're pairing something with this meal?
I would look for the weight of the dish. So are we enjoying something that's really quite rich, or are we eating something that's kind of soft and delicate?
Okay.
That I really feel is rule number one.
So my instinct would say that this is rich.
This is definitely rich, a richer style.
Okay.
You know, steak has got big and bold flavors. We need a wine to really pair and match and come up and meet that big, bold flavor.
Rise to the challenge.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so what have we got here?
So today I paired, this is a Syrah from Mooncursor Vineyards. It's an Okanagan Valley wine, one of my favorites. Syrah is quite a rich wine. It's got lots of perfume, beautiful bouquet and aromas to it, and it really goes well with steak. So it's a medium to full-bodied style. It's got loads of black currant, cassis, a little spice, and it really pairs well with beef.
Delicious.
If I don't knock it over.
Yeah. And you've got some other ones here.
I do have some other obviously choices, right?
Yeah.
You know, we spoke about barbecuing. The rule with me, and it comes to pairing wines with a barbecue, is you want wines that are really aromatic. You don't want anything that's delicate and going to be lost. You know, barbecues, we generally have a lot of flavors, a lot of different flavors. So you want wines that are really gonna stand up to those flavors. Nothing subtle about these wines.
Okay, good. Yeah. So subtle is not the name of the game here.
No, definitely not.
Cool.
No.
Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Perfect.
Thank you.
And that does it for us here on Go Kamloops at Hoodoos at Sun Rivers. Thank you so much for joining us. We wanna see your pictures. If you spend the afternoon out cooking on the barbecue, sipping some wine, share them with us online at Shaw TV Kamloops on Facebook and Twitter. And if you have a story idea or an event listing, you can also email us at go_Kamloops@shaw.ca. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.